Hey guys, welcome to Season 3, Episode 2 of my Let's Play series. Now, I'm sorry for the late upload, guys, but we've had a little bit of trouble with our telephone line. It was down so long and we didn't have internet, and when we had internet, it was so slow that it kept cutting out. So they put in a temporary line at the moment, and for now we have internet again. Was the last episode we left off with me looking for that chest. I found it and dumped all our stuff, so now we have enough space for everything else we need. We're going to keep going, and this time we're going to go for... we restarted this path. Okay, so we're going to keep going and see if we can take a left turn towards the hub. Because this is the hub. There should be two entrances to the hub. Let's just get some stone for ourselves so we can make more arrows. My brother and I were actually really stressing because we didn't know what was going to happen since we couldn't upload anything. We had serious troubles with our internet. It was the worst so far. We might just need to make another drop chest along the way, because I just have this feeling we're going to fill up soon. It seems the road splits up ahead, so we'll just still see if we can take a left or not. That almost ended in disaster. I almost forgot we're playing on warrior difficulty, so I didn't take that zombie seriously. Damn stag. Did it drop now? Oh, not yet. Let's see if we can hit him from here. I don't know if we're aiming too low or too high, have to get closer. I'm just going to gather as much meat as I can, as soon as I can. But now he's going too far, and I don't think the bleeding effect lasts that long. As soon as I get to about 200 arrows, I'll start making more. Oh, she's down there. For a moment there, I thought she was next to me. Anyways, how was your guys' weekends and week so far? I can't say weekend because it hasn't been that long, but it actually feels so long. Come on. What the hell? I feel that first one hit. It's a real shame that we're behind schedule now, because I wanted to start that other game as well and upload that tomorrow, but I wanted to today. Well, I'm recording this on Thursday, and this video was supposed to be out on Thursday already. How did this one kill in one shot and the other one ran away? I actually want to try and save up this knife because we need it for animal skinning. I'm actually recording this video at 10 at night, so I wanted to see if I can do quite a few videos in succession now, but I'll think tomorrow morning I have to do quite a few just to get ahead of this, because I don't want to make an episode just before the day I have to upload it. It's just too much of a strain. Just see where we are on the map. We have to take a left soon. Damn it. I was hoping we'd find a road much sooner. Or a road that leads to the city at least. Oh well, at least we're getting to explore this place and perhaps find a new prefab. I just have to make sure that I find a temporary prefab before the day 7 horde. It will suck to have no place to stay and then have to face a horde. Just imagine if bicycles were a thing in this game. You find a bicycle next to a road and you can go twice as fast than walking. And then the mini bike speeds depend on the minimum speed of the bicycle. During the night I have to break down quite a few stones more, boulders, and then also cut down a few trees so that we can actually start getting our weapons and toolsmithing up, especially our toolsmithing. I cannot afford to die this soon. I have to be more careful. Okay, let's be on our way. I want to build inside the hub for my main base, but for the temporary base I need to get something outside until I have a shotgun or something to defend myself with in the city. No point in going to the hub city and then dying from dogs and stuff. We're actually doing quite well on hides and meat. I think the only reason I'm getting a slight stutter now is because it's a new area I'm discovering. It's not the same as the lag we experienced during the previous season. Oh shit. I was really hoping we'd cut around the area. Just see, we have to have enough space. If we take duct tape, how much cloth do we have? Not a lot. Damn, I thought we could have enough cloth to actually do what I intended to do. Okay, let's see. This is going back into the hub. Because I've just as well gone through here, since this is wasteland and burnt biome. Just keep our ears open for dogs. One dog at a time is fine on an even road, but if it gets to a slanted road, we're screwed with the pathing of the zombies. At least we have the pistol. One or two shots should do a trick for the dog. If you can get it in the face. I think for now I'm just gonna try and miss all the zombies, or pass all the zombies, sorry, so that I don't waste ammo and that we can get out of this area soon. I just hope that if there is a dog here somewhere, is that Wasteland? If there is a dog here somewhere, we see it before it actually starts attacking us. We'll actually be considered extremely lucky if we can get through this area without dog seeing us. The only thing I don't like that much is the amount of hills in the Alpha 15 game. There's way too many hills around. I mean, are you telling me post-apocalypse nuke or something dropped that changed the terrain? I need to get to shelter before nighttime. So hopefully we get out of this area soon. Even if I have to take a prefab in this area, that would be fine. As long as we at least find a prefab to stay in. Damn, I actually need that. We'll just see if we can kill this guy and quickly get it. Oh, cool. I think that was a crit hit. You know what? No, I don't want to make a drop chest in this area. If it wasn't a burnt biome, I would have made a drop chest. I'll rather drop those things since we can get them later on. I apologize if it's a little dark for you guys, but unfortunately I haven't found a mining helmet yet. I'm actually surprised that I can one-shot them. I think it has to be a clear shot to the head. Since lead is so abundant in the game, there's no reason to pick up any lead while you're looting. I mean, just go to any forest biome and then look on top of the surface. I have the sneaking suspicion that we're actually nearing a town. I hope that's the case, since we can make our temporary base in a town and then our main base in the Hype City itself. It'll actually suck if we run into the Hype City directly now. Even though that's our objective. Just see where we are. So we're actually getting very close to the city at the moment. Who knows, I might just die in this series. Last series it was so easy because it was the default difficulty. But this time with Warrior, you saw how long it takes just to kill a dog. Oh damn it, there's a schematic in there. I'll have to start making arrows soon just to make a little bit of space for the rest of the stuff. Let's see, where does this lead? No end in sight. I'm not sure, I haven't seen a Hype City yet, except for the previous season. So I wonder if it's still like Alpha 14, where the Hype City could be different biomes, or if it's stuck on just being that one biome, the wasteland area. We definitely need more space in our inventory, so I need to make a drop chest. And I just have a feeling that we're gonna get to the hub before nightfall. So we might just make a drop chest there. If I can find a prefab close to the hub. then I'll make a drop chest there, just to make it safer for us to retrieve the stuff. For a moment there, that stag looked like a dog. Unfortunately, I do not have time to hunt these two since I need to get to a safe place before nightfall. This almost seems like a cut straight through from the other side. In that case, it would have been a shortcut to take. Damn, we're nearing the up city. I might just have to run past all the zombies I see and try and get to a place to stay. Hopefully we don't die before I can actually place something down. It'd actually be kind of awesome to start the series by looting the Up City, although I'd like to get Quality Joe to maximum before doing that. Oh yes, prefab. So I'm gonna put a chest there and then see where the Up City is and see if we can get to the Up City tonight, or if we can just use this prefab for now for safety, because we need to get inside before dark. That looks like it goes over the hill. Yep, straight to the hub. So let's clear out this prefab quickly and lay down a chest. We also need to find a boulder there. So after we kill all the zombies, we break that boulder and make a few more arrows. Damn, now just to get my aim straight. Please don't sneak up on me. I hate the burning sound these guys make. It's so loud that you can't hear zombies sneak up. Did those zombies get nerfed? These fire zombies. Usually they took twice as many shots as all the other zombies. I have to hurry and get inside before nightfall. During the night, I'll definitely have to beef up this place. Perhaps take out the stairs here and there and make ladders. Okay, so we have an X there, so we can move our sleeping bag to this side. Just so we can spawn here when we die in the Up City. Let's quickly get some stone and then we build this place up. Oh, I can't believe we're lagging again. I really thought the lag was over. Okay, we have grass, wood, and stone, so we can make a stone axe. Scrap this. I wonder if it's just because we're close to the hub city. I hope so. I'll have to check if that other program put itself on again or not. Seems we do more damage with a stone axe than with the... with a pickaxe. There are zombies in the area, but that's fine. As long as the dogs don't sneak up on us, we'll be fine for the night. During the night, I'll have to be super careful because I need to cut down more trees for more wood. The more wood and resources we have on us, the faster we'll be able to upgrade and defend a place in the hub city. Let's just, for security's sake, take more. This is the last level of this boulder. It's almost 10. I actually wanted to see if I can find the hub city before then, but it doesn't look like that's gonna happen. At least we know we're super close to it, so that's okay. Okay, now I'm just gonna take out these stairs and then I'll see you guys back in the morning. See you guys then. Hey guys, as you can see, during the night I cleared out this building. I think I most likely will cut in the part of where I found this pistol. I found it in the desk. So I'll put that part in and then the rest will cut out, and then I looted the rest of this. Also during the night we had zombie issues, but at least I was able to get away from them. And I also marked this spot on the map so we know where we are. Okay, I dropped everything else and let's go. As you can see, I put this here to get wooden stuff, but the zombies, they're still here. The zombie surprised me, so I had to get up. I should actually make more of these, otherwise I'm gonna get screwed later on. That being said, let me make it now, otherwise I am gonna forget. Let's just make five for now. See where we are, go there. Okay, and now today we should find the hub city. I really hate it when the heads get stuck and stuff like that. I mean, usually in real life you'll be able to hit the head if it's just a little bit against something, but that's something else entirely. I actually hope we find the hub today and we don't find any dogs, because if we don't find any dogs then we'll be able to scout the city a bit and find a place to stay. Who knows, maybe our very first base or temp base is going to be our main base. It all depends on what the prefab we find is. I'm actually hoping for a prison or something like that. Something that's already almost fully secured. It's a shame that I reloaded that other gun, because I didn't know I was gonna find a better gun so soon. Just gonna keep this on me since we're entering the wasteland now, and there are dogs in the wasteland. So I need to be prepared for that. Oh, this is a shitty terrain. At least there's a forest, but still. I have to run through the whole town, or the whole hub city, just to find the best place to go. This almost looks like the one... the unstable builds we tried. This almost looks like one of those builds, because we took a path like this and then I applied on our right side. Our first pooch. I wonder if I can run. I wonder if I can outrun it. Let's try. If not, I'll use the ammo. If I can, then cool, we save ammo. Damn, if this place wasn't leeched, I might have used this. Oh, they gave me a fright. Damn, they gave me a big fright. So they can catch you now, damn it. If that place wasn't glitched, I'd do the same as I did in, I think it was Alpha 14, where I made that my base. Unfortunately, that is not the case, since it's glitched. And you can't fix that glitch no matter what you do. Okay, now I have to be careful. Only 12 ammo left, so if I face a dog now, I should actually try the bow first. And then, if I miss too much, switch to the gun. Because I have to conserve this ammo now. I actually prefer this lack of spawn. As you guys know, in the previous series, we played max spawn, and there was just too many zombies. Yeah, it's more, well, since it's a hub, it should actually be a lot more zombies. But, okay, let's see if we can run away from the cop at least. We don't have enough ammo to kill this one. There's quite a few rundown buildings to choose from. But what I'm looking for is a proper house that we can move into. Something with mostly all its walls intact. If only I had the time, I could stop there and loot. But I need to find a place to stay before I do any looting. It's imperative that I find a place to stay first. Luckily, there's quite a few shops and stuff here, so if dogs come now, or too many zombies, you can just climb a ladder. Okay, so that's the morgue. That is forest biome, another tool shop. Two tool shops, gun shop, and a shanty town. And a ton of bees. A bank. Even a cafe. Ooh, a bookstore, yes, awesome. Another gun store. This place has quite a few shops, I can tell you that. Damn. I'm just going to get a little bit closer to the forest side and check the ground so we don't step on a mine. So I want to get a place closer to the forest than to the rest of the place. Okay, there's our hotel. Damn, I might just have to live in a hotel again. I actually don't like the hotel, since we've done that so many times before. But if we have to live in a hotel, we have to live in a hotel. We might just do a standalone base later on, right next to the hub city. But for now, I definitely want to build in the hub. Damn, I didn't take that torch with me. Apologize, guys, it's gonna get a little bit dark in here. I should actually have cleared the other areas first before coming to this side. So, I mean, if I could have looted the other bookstore as well, I'd have twice the knowledge. Or just twice the junk, depending on what we get. Oh yes, shotgun. Or rather schematic. Since we can just as well clean out the whole place. Hopefully we get a pistol schematic in the shop, so we can finally take away, take apart all those pistols. The pistol and then this one we just found. Remember, they almost said all those pistols, but we only have three in total. Actually probably drink a little bit of water since it's so hot. Yeah, you actually dehydrate a lot faster. I could actually set the gamma a little lower so you guys can see better, but then I'm gonna have a little bit of trouble when I go outside because everything's gonna be too bright. I might just not have the time to just read that for in case I might not have the time to set it back to normal. Wait, I thought this was a blue one. Now I see it's purple. Come on, give me a damn pistol book. A guy, okay, that's at least good. When my tool skill is at least yellow or green level and I have a steel pickaxe, I'll come back to this area and loot all the gun safes and wall safes. That includes all the prefabs we've gone past by now. Just see, there's a mechanical parts for us. Okay, so we're going to leave all that for now. I'm not going to waste the time breaking through that with a stone axe. Just quickly see how much time we have left, and then see if we can at least find a place to stay this episode. There's more than enough time. Okay, let's quickly see. I'll also go onto the roofs when I go for the gun safes and wall safes. There's no point in going onto the roof now when I am in desperate need of a place to stay. While there are no zombies around us, let's just quickly scrap the... No, scrap... Come on, first these, because they take faster, and then lastly the one that takes a few minutes, or rather a minute. Okay, I wanted to go through there so we can get more of a look at the hub city, but I'm afraid of landmines. So let's just run on the outer side and see if we can find a place to stay. But guys, to be honest, I think we're going to have to live in that hotel. We can make that our... I don't want to make that our main base. Maybe that will be our horde base slash hub base. Ooh, already another dog. Damn it. We could use the apartment complex, but that's a little too weak. Damn it. Took a little bit more damage than I thought I would. Only have a measly 5. Ooh, yes, we find our place to stay. Only have a measly 5 shots left, so I have to be careful now. Please tell me this is not the glitch. Yes, it is. Damn it. Okay, I'll just have to break out that wall and then try and do something there. For now, even this side. This is gonna make it almost impossible to live here. I'll just have to break out these corners. Let's see if there's another glitch spot. That's what I hate about the game. There's so many bugs, even here. This whole area is unplaceable. I can't place there in between. Okay, so might not be this place, but the place next door. At least there's walls for us. Okay, now only 2 ammo left, so the next dog that comes, I'm screwed. But, like I said... Damn it. Another dog right off the bat. Come on. Just have to make one frame so that I know where to save the stuff to. Because if I pick up these frames, they're gonna fall in here. But now I can go for that place. So I'm gonna make a base there for now and then upgrade it a little bit. And then I'm gonna give you guys the option of what I should do next. Should I perhaps use the hotel again, or would you guys want me to see build my own place but with the walls defending me there? Come and get a quick screenshot. Okay, let's kill these guys. If I hear vomit, I have to move. Because that's gonna kill me. I'm gonna have to run. There's no way I can kill this cop. Or at least let's try. If I can get him to run and then just run away, I might be safe. Make no mistake, I am gonna have to run because there's no way I can survive a blast from this guy. As soon as he explodes, I'll die. Even at that height. Already another dog I hear, so I have to get up here. Damn these dogs. Be careful of that bee so it doesn't get us. Come on, kill these guys. They might just destroy my wall before I even have it up. Damn it. I have to keep moving. I'm wasting so much ammo, and I left all my other arrows at the prefab, in the drop chest. I'll have to set my sights on getting cement mix as soon as possible so I can upgrade this wall. Also get a lot of wood so I can make some spikes. Come on. Bullseye. One more. Okay, I was able to defend myself. Now, where's that bee? Only the one. We can quickly get off here. And now that no zombies or dogs are around, we can quickly loot these guys. Come on, come on, come on. There's actually a ton of zombies. I thought there weren't going to be that many zombies, but clearly I was wrong. Okay, so we're going to use this as an outer wall. Where is that bee? So far away, but the shadow looks so close. Okay, so I wanted to use that place, but as you guys can see, there's too many glitched holes in the wall. So for now, I'm going to put my sleeping bag on top of that place. And then hopefully, we either get a better place than this, or you guys are okay with me building in the hotel. Three should be enough for now. Yep. Okay, so it's gonna be... Damn it. Give me some honey, please. I'm infected. Okay, I got honey, but I just need to pick it up now. Drop that there. Honey, and then place this there. So actually, everything's going well so far. Is this roof? Okay, I can come in like this. We're actually doing quite well, if you think about it. We have a place to stay now in the hub. We didn't die, although we got extremely close to dying. We have clothing to cool us down, and... Now, come on. Now, we're infection-free. Awesome. We can scrap this. Scrap that, eat a little. What is our water levels at? Okay, I'm gonna make a drop chest here as well. And then also we have to gather a little bit of, just let's see where this is. We have to gather a little bit of plant fiber so we can make our bedroll here. Getting the new design for the chests. It's a cool design, but I'm still not used to it. Okay, let's just quickly get... We have frames to get back up if something chases us. And now get some plant fibers. The only problem I have with this area is the fact that it's half blocks on top and that there's iron bars here. I'll have to take the iron bars out and then complete this whole wall. I just hope it's an uneven number because for my perfectionism, I need something that has a door in the middle. I can't take two doors or a door offset from the middle. Okay, bedroll. Drop all of these. Unfortunately, we didn't find the schematic for that. But I'm going to try and go back and see if we can loot the other, or read the other books in the other bookstore. Okay, put this in there. Can put this in there. We're going to use that later. The hub's not that big, eh? I actually thought it was going to be a lot bigger than this. Because the last one we had was this much. Okay, so I'm just going to call the episode here, and then next episode we're going to keep searching this area here, perhaps down this road to see if we can find any more buildings, and then we're going to loot all these stores. Hopefully we get a pistol schematic from that other bookstore. Anyways, if you guys like this episode, please leave a like and share with your friends. If you have any comments or feedback, please leave that down below, as well as your opinion on me staying in the hotel. See, this dog is coming closer. Let's quickly kill this guy. Me living in a hotel or not, is it okay, since we did do that quite a few times already? I don't want to bore you guys by building in the same hotel again. And if you guys are new to this channel, please remember to subscribe for more 7 Days to Die content. See you guys next time.